lady, excuse me. You're causing quite a disturbance over here. I want everyone to see this.
Peace, peace, everyone. My name is Chani Kinsler, also known as CK the Poet, and this is a new Black Knowledge special. Today we're going to go way back when. In 1868, one of the first Black schools, Fessenden Academy, played a pivotal role in the advancement of Black people in Marion County, Florida. Despite the racism, discrimination, segregation, and Jim Crow laws. Originally called the Union School, it was an old log cabin on an acre of land donated by Frank Kane's plantation, and the construction was financed by Thomas B. Ward. After slavery, the Freedmen's Bureau offered much assistance to newly freed Blacks so far as schooling, housing, and land. Some of the courses this school taught were blacksmith, carpentry, sewing, math, writing, housework, cooking, and so much more. The public was very hostile towards tax money going to Blacks and whites teaching Blacks in their county. In 1890, Ferdinand Fessenden saw potential in the school and decided to invest in the future of the ambitious knowledge seekers and ensured that they had books, desks, and maps. The school was later sponsored through the American Missionary Association, also known as AMA. This was a Protestant abolitionist group that played a major role during the Reconstruction era, promoting education for Blacks in the South. The Union School was later renamed Fessenden Academy and Industrial School in the early 1900s. Ferdinand Fessenden bought the land the school was on, and construction began. Built by the very Black people that would be going there for an education, the school even had separate areas for the students to sleep. There were strict rules against cursing, fighting, guns, smoking, and drinking. The school upheld strict Christian values. Unfortunately, Mr. Fessenden died in 1899. Per his request, he was buried on the school grounds where there is a tombstone to remember him by. One prominent Black man, Joseph L. Wiley, was a principal at Fessenden Academy. He was vital in securing much-needed funds for the school to expand the space, services, and grade levels. Under his leadership, while he was there, more than 1,000 students graduated from the school. But in 1915, he vanished, never to be found again. Another prominent African-American, John A. Budge, was the director in the 1940s, and he implemented curriculum changes and added programs to make African Americans more prepared to go to college or university. The AMA tried to sell the school to the state of Florida in the 1940s, but it was unsuccessful. The school closed down in the 1950s and was purchased by Marion County, but continued to operate as a vocational school. The school is still standing today. It went from being a high school, a middle school, but currently is being used as an elementary school as part of the public school system, teaching more than 400 students from various demographic backgrounds. That was my presentation. I wanted to thank everybody for watching. Hopefully you like and favorite the video. Definitely subscribe to New Black Knowledge. I decided to do my presentation on Fessenden Academy because of my family on both my mother and father's side, extensive history of going to this school in the late 1800s, early 1900s, and also going to the first Black school in the area that was built a year before this school called Howard Academy. Look forward to me doing a video on that in the future. And I hope you learned something today. And as True Story says, each one teach one. NBK, way, every day, all day. Peace.